All right, let's keep it moving here. Let's go and let's take a look into the Zoom, right? So the Zoom works a little bit different ways, right? Of course, you can always kind of go to a stock and you can change it towards having it at a kind of auto, right? In the top right, you can see here the scale. The scale is going to be very important. You can always right click here also to adjust the scale, right? So absolute, relative, logarithmic, right? There's different ways you can do it. You can also change it right here to auto and manual. I do use the manual sometimes. It just depends on the stock, right? So like, let's say like a different stock that you want to see like every penny, like, so like this, right? It's only showing me every 10 cent increments, but it could be a stock that moves very slowly. And I want to say, look into it a little bit more. So if I looked into the intraday, I can actually pull it here and expand it here and kind of zoom in a little bit. Or maybe I just want to make it less active, right? Well, if I make it tiny here, it's going to help me, right? And I can also move it here in the manual. When it's locked in auto, you're not going to be able to move the chart as much up and down, right? You can see you can move left and right. That's fine too. And then at the bottom, you also have an ability to move left and right between the times also. So don't forget that you have that. You got zoom out and zoom in, and you can also do these previews, right? When you scroll over it, you can have this preview kind of set. It could take you right to that spot, right? That's why you use the previews, and you can see the time at the bottom there that will help you out to kind of catch what you're doing there. So definitely take a look into the preview action of the chart. All right, let's keep it moving. Let's take a look at some different action there. Of course, auto scale mode and manual is going to help you guys out. Definitely fit the indicators in and things like that. You can also do a manual refresh for some people that feel like maybe the data is being a little bit weird or something. There's always a refresh right here. Hit that refresh so that you can have things go ahead and repopulate. All right, let's take a look at different action. There's also different options. There's different time periods. You can do kind of different periods, right? You can add, of course, if you want to go in here, you can take a look to see, hey, I want to add different things here. Well, there's different things right here on the different data type. If I want to look at the bid, I want to look at the ask, I want to look at that situation, you can do that just with the right click, right? You can also hit view and see different things. Like I can do the day's high and the previous close, and maybe it's a previous percentage sentiment, right? This previously closed at 7.08. It's very important to know that we're getting above that action. And you can even do on the grid time and different things like this. This is definitely going to help you out. And of course, if you want to take a look at, maybe you're trying to take a look at the after hours action and things like that, that's going to be very important to kind of add into it here. So of course, you guys have to look into the settings and kind of adjust that. You can go into different colors and things like this. We'll talk a little bit more about that in just a little bit. But if you go to the time scale area and you look here at the appearance, you'll find here show, and you can see holes in history. Yeah, show me those holes in history. Show me the extended session, right? I want to see what's going on there. You can also highlight the date, right? I got a day separator right now that separates it by a line, but you could separate weeks, months, even years, and then just apply it. Another thing that is it's important is to understand that you can also add these to all the charts, right? Bottom left corner is going to give you an ability to reset to factory, reset to default, or set it as default. And that way, every time you make a new chart, it's the same way that you want it set up. So that's a big thing to take a look into, team. I definitely say go ahead and see that, guys. All right, that's going to do it for the first part of this. Let's keep it going. Let's take a look at different action. Of course, I talked about the data source. You guys can definitely take a look into that. Well, let's take a look into the way that you change the colors, right? So like, let's say if maybe I wanted to make the background just white. Okay, maybe I just like that, right? Well, there it is. It's kind of ugly like that, but we won't talk about that. We'll just go back to our dark blue. I like the dark blues. I like black. Black is also an option, right? You can just go black. Here, some people like the black charts, right? It just depends on what you like. For me, I like doing it as dark blue, and then I want to see the watermark. The watermark, I like to show the symbol, but if you wanted to add the symbol name, you could also add it here. You can change kind of there. You guys see it now. I can see that it's the advisor share pure cannabis ETF. I can also change the color the opacity, right? If I want to make it a little bit darker, things like that are definitely going to help you. I definitely recommend that you have that so you can see it. Another thing is the crosshair. I like to do crosshair. You guys can definitely change that up and do it a different ways, but this can definitely help you guys try to find different things. You guys can see that I really love to make things kind of stand out to me, and it's very important to go ahead and do so. And definitely, you guys can also take a look into different grids. Maybe you want to add the horizontal grid. You can definitely do that, and that starts to put lines on the charts. It's all dependent on how you want things to look. And never forget that there's always colors and changes that you can make adjustments to try to help you. All right, let's keep going. We'll talk about some more action here as we keep moving to the next part of it. But we can also take a look at how to add maybe multiple charts, right? Maybe you want multiple charts on one screen. Well, that's going to be more of your terminal, and you're going to go here and you're going to hit grid. So grid is going to give you something like this, where you can have two stocks on one chart, right? Or maybe you just want to have the same stock on one, right? Maybe you want to have the SPY here, and you want to have the daily chart on the right-hand side and the 15-minute on one side. This can go ahead and help you see that as you pull back here on this quick pullback, this is just going back right here on the pullback of the daily and giving you an opportunity to get that on the daily low and on the 15-minute turnaround, right? Things like this, multi-time frame trades are going to help you guys have an advantage. Definitely take a look into the grid. Click this right here and you can change the grid. Let's say if I just wanted three charts. Well, there you guys have it. Three charts, right? You can put it underneath it. It's all up to you on how you want your panel size to be. And don't forget, you can change the colors on here and have different stocks, different order forms, and kind of adjust it. It's very important to kind of play with that, but something that I would look into. There's a lot of other things, right, to look into when you were looking into charts. Another thing that I think is very important to look into is making sure that you go through each one of these, right? You can go through the data style. You can kind of play with that action. You can go into the view. You can start painting the watermark and things like that. You can look into your time scales. We've talked about some of those actions. But one of the things that I think is very important is the price scale. As we go into the price scales, you'll see different things like highlighting prices and the scale marker, the ask, the bid. Those are things right here on the right-hand side. So I like to look into this spread type and actually put line with price. A lot of times you'll have this set as none. Why do I put the line with price? Is that this actually gives me what you see on the screen right now, where you see the plus and the minus, where you see the offered line and you see a bid line. This keeps it right there on the chart. So I don't even need to look into the order form to know that it's trading around that kind of 104, right, pricing. Well, this one's not connected to it, but I'll go to Tesla so you can see it at 250.27, the 250.08, and I put it those same colors so that it looks very similar to the way the order form looks like, but it gives you the ability to see it right there on the chart. So definitely take a look into that. I think it's one of the best ways to stay with the price action, especially on those fast movers.